things and desires. One of them is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَعْبُدْهُ وَاسْطَبِرْ لِعِبَادَتِهِ رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَأَرْضِ. Lord of earth and heavens and whatever is in between them, فَعْبُدْهُ, worship Him. And then Allah said also, وَاسْطَبِرْ لِعِبَادَتِهِ, and have sabr or patience on His ibadah. That tells you there's two kinds of sabr, two kinds of patience. Sabrun ala ta'a, sabr to do the ta'a, the obedience, wa sabrun anil ma'asiyah, and sabr that prevents you from doing sins. Because sins appeal, zuyyana linnas, sins appeal to the nafs al ammara, the nafs. So you have to have sabr to prevent yourself from going into these sins, and then you have to develop a sabr to sustain yourself on the ta'a of Allah. And that's why Allah says, wastabir li'ibad, wastabir li'ibadatik. Have sabr on His ibadah. Develop that sabr. I know it's not easy, you're standing there, shaitan is coming not only from one way, five different ways. You say, wait a minute, shaitan is supposed to be in prison now, federal penitentiary. maximum security. Yeah, but that's the shaitan of jinn. Shaitan of jinn is incarcerated. But the shaitan of ins, mashallah, is roaming free. Everywhere, shayateen. And guess who's more dangerous nowadays? The shaitan of the jinn or the shaitan of the ins? Oh, you know, shaitan of the ins can teach shaitan of the jinn lessons. There is a narration, I'll tell you the story again. Today is weekend, so I can tell the story a little bit. That supposedly Al-Hasan al-Basri saw a tabi'i, rahimahullah radhi anhu, saw shaitan in his dream. He told him, man, shaitan, stop misguiding people. You know, you're 24/7 all this time, you know, full time. You're doing this, misguiding people. He told him, Ya Abu Sa'id, Hasan al-Basri, his name is Abu Sa'id. He says, Ya Abu Sa'id, Ya Abu Sa'id, that was in the long, long days ago, long time ago, we used to teach them how to be misguided. Now we learn from them. Now we learn from the human beings how to be misguided. Not the other way around. Anyway, regardless, that's why Allah the Quran Kareem said, Shayateen al-jinni wal-ins. Not Shayateen al-insi wal-jinn. Shayateen al-insi wal-jinn. Not Shayateen al-jinni wal-ins. He puts the Shayateen of ins before the Shayateen of jinn. Because there's no. So therefore, your nafs will come to you from different kinds. Says, man, you have to pray all this. You do have to do this. You know, how, maybe you don't understand what this, maybe that. Look, there's other fun things you can do. All kinds of stuff. You have to have that sabr on the ta'a. Sabr on the ta'a. That takes me to the ayah before this surah he's reading. The one in Surah Al-Kahf where Allah says, قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيْهِ. And this ayah, you know, it always talks about two things. Say, I am a human being like you, yuha ilayhi, that receives wahy. This ayah actually talks about two things, basar and basira. Basar and basira. Qul innama ana basharun mithlukum, yani tell them, Ya Rasulullah, I'm a human being like you. Yuha ilayhi, I receive wahy. The first portion of the ayah you can understand with basar, because you can see basharun mithlukum, you can see human being like you. But the basira, which is the vision of the heart. Basar is vision of the eye. Basira is vision of the heart. You can see basharun mithlukum with your eyes, but you can never see yuha ilayhi with your eyes. You have to have vision of the heart, basira, to see. That's why the Quran effectively is saying, there are many people with basar, they have eyes, but there is no basira, there is no vision of the heart. They can see, قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ, I am a human being like you. They say, بَعَثَ اللَّهُ بَشَرًا رَسُولًا, this is بَشَرًا رَسُولًا, this is a bashar. They see what their eyes see. They have vision of the eyes. لكن their heart is dead. Therefore, they cannot see يُوحَى إِلَيْهِ. For this, you have to have vision of the heart. You have to have iman in the heart. If there is no iman in the heart, you can be with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم like Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab. Years they lived with him, but they didn't see يُوحَى إِلَيْهِ. All they saw is بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. Therefore, they couldn't believe in him صلى الله عليه وسلم. The heart is dead. If the qalb is dead, That's why Allah says in another ayah, إِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَ الْأَبْصَارِ. Visions are not blind, the ayah means. وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَ الْقُلُومِ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. But what's blind are the hearts. That's what's blind. It doesn't hurt you if you have lost your eyesight, because you can still make it. But you'll definitely lose your ways in the dunya and akhirah if you lose your heart sight. And for that, there are no glasses. The only thing that can make it transparent and visible is iman. That's why Allah said in the Quran, "Man kana fi hadhihi a'ma, fahuwa fil akhirati a'ma wa dhalu sabila." Whoever is blind in this dunya, blind of what? With the eyes? No. There are many people, Sahaba were blind. Abdullah bin Maktoum radiallahu anhu was blind. Sayyidina Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu towards the end of his life was blind. So does the ayah says whoever is blind in this dunya is blind in the akhirah? No. It's not talking about the blindness of the eye. The ayah is talking about the blindness of the heart. If you are blind in the heart, surely you will be blind in dunya, and furthermore, you'll be even more blinded in the akhirah. May Allah give us that vision of the heart.
Amen.
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.